Operational report. Submarines detected. Repairs complete. Repairs complete. Oh, all the sub chasers are coming out of refit at Guam. Repairs complete. Vancouver. Contact report. Contact report. Oh, hey, Catalina supposedly hits I-70. Oh, 95. This is on the Gold Coast, I believe. Contact reports from the B-25s at Singapore and Vengeance dive bombers. Kill credit. Kill credit. Recon over Okayama. Fukuyama. Recon Langkawi. Tanjung Pinang. Chichi-jima. Okayama. And Fukuyama again. Oh, contact report. Contact report. Recon over Matsue. Matsue again. Recon. Repairs complete. Expansion. Iwo expands. That's how you build an airfield and a port at the same time, you lazy bastards. Ahahajima. Alora Star expands. Oh, just the port, though. We're taking replacements. Oh, crud! Gotta watch out for this one. Okay. The Chindits that I tried to sneak into Kota Baru, somehow they've upgraded. Ah! Okay, we got to make sure. We'll double check on that one. Repairs complete. All the sub-changes coming out at Guam. Repairs complete. Pearl Harbor. This is reinforcements. Alameda, Los Angeles. Look at all these reinforcements. Anti-aircraft arriving at Madras. Air wings arriving at Aden, Madras. Lots of Soviets. And a supply convoy at Cape Town. First order of business is to take care of that Kota Baru. We have to look at the Chindits. How did you? Okay. Well, they upgraded already, so we've got six squads here. Look at that, six different squads here. Some of them have somehow upgraded. I don't know. Because they're so small, hopefully they'll still be able to recombine if I put them together. I just don't know. Okay, Mr. Catalina, we're going to make sure we stop transporting them. Oh, or should we take another batch over? Putting 12 squads on, it's not a lot. It's not a lot. There should be enough combat value here. Let's take a look at the Kota Baru. If we drop these guys, that's a assault value of 3. That should be enough to take an empty base once we blast the hell out of everything, every living thing on Langkawi. So I'm going to make sure we turn off the... Yeah, I'll turn them off. I'll take that risk. We'll put them back on naval search. 80%, 20. There we go. The next thing we'll take a look at is we'll call up the ground units. We'll call up all the ground units. This is a very nice little function. Very nice little function that was introduced. I think it was not in Admiral's edition. It wasn't available in others. Okay, so we're going to call up. We're going to take a look at all the Soviet units. Since the Soviet units cannot move, there's really no point. We'll sort according to the reinforcements on or off. Notice all these guys, all these new ones coming, show no reinforcements. So I'm going to turn on all the reinforcements for these guys. All the new guys are getting new reinforcements. And the... Oh, God. Really? These guys are having them turned off because I don't want them to take reinforcements when they withdraw. I could, yeah. I could have just set for all to turn on all the replacements and all the reinforcements, but then that would have turned on these two, and I'd have to find these two damn things again, so forget that. We'll also turn on the upgrades for all the newly arrived units. So maybe it isn't as convenient as it was, but at least you can find them and filter them a little bit. Still a god-awful gazillion freaking clicks! One at a miserable time! But at least it's possible. Over in Hong Kong, all submarines are still under refit. Taking a look at Shanghai, we have Capelin is going to be under refit. Okay, so she's also in repair. So we're going to drop her in right now, Capelin. Put her into refit, or into pier side, and she'll refit anyway. The Puffer, oddly, did not refuel. Okay, refuel. Make sure Puffer refuels and rearms. There we go, fully rearmed. We're at the last day of the month. So July 1st is coming around, and there could be some more refits on there. So it's now important to check. We have to check just a little bit ahead. Not allowed next month. See, we have to check for this month and next month. But these are all right. So we've got 2, 4, 6 submarines, 2 for each patrol station. Ah, yes, now we bring fighters over to Fuchao, and of course the AI, oh, so intelligently, avoids them! Yeah, that kind of bullshit nonsense. Oh, yeah, the AI looks, sees there's something there, oh, we'll attack something else now. Who else gets to look at that? Garbage. Okay, so he tried to bomb up Sui Tao. Sui Tao has no base force here. So I guess I'll have to move some fighters over here too, just... The AI forces you to defend every god-awful garrison here. Because I can't just leave this damn thing. It's got a garrison requirement. So I can't abandon it. So I either let the AI bomb or defend the damn thing. And you can't defend... I tried to defend from Amoy. The range at Amoy, 3. There aren't enough fighters. You'd have to put 300 or 400 fighters... No, not 300. Probably closer to 100 or 200 fighters here in order to get any leakage out here to cover this one. Because at a range of 3, you just can't get enough fighters to cover the area. So what'll happen is I try to defend Fuchao that way, and then, oh, so I'd end up having out of how many fighters? Oh, 24 fighters here? 24. I'd end up having one fighter over here, and the AI coming with 10 or 12, even crappy fighters, would shoot the hell out of it. So I'm just serving up my pilots to commit suicide. So I've got a flight on Fuchao, I've got to put a flight on Amoy to cover these two, and I've got to put another squadron on Sui Tao to cover these two. Bullshit! Right? So we got the... At least we have an extra one here. I'm going to move one of these base forces down the road. So we'll waste another one of these little squadrons over here just to fly around in circles. At least when I'm using when I'm wasting squadrons like this, I can use them for training and, yeah, training up pilots, fighter pilots, and training up bomber pilots. See, these guys, it's a real easy mission. If the AI doesn't attack, just like over in Pakoi's been flying P-40 kilos. Look at how many we have to fly in order to keep the enemy, oh, here's another one. In order to keep the enemy from bombing, we have to fly a whole bunch of them, 24 around here, or else the enemy comes in and bombs Nanning and Quang Chauan. So we have to fly it, but I guess it's just the price of doing business. We fly it to keep the AI from bombing. And I use these as trainers. Look at them, gaining experience. Just flying around in circles. Now that's fine. There's no combat here. Same happening in Hong Kong. Just flying around in circles. Doing nothing. The AI won't challenge it because it's too strong. And that's the whole point. Make it strong enough so that the AI doesn't even bother. What a waste of time. We killed the two ships over at Fukuyama. Nice bombing. A little bit of port damage. But nothing that costs supplies to repair. But it is nice to see the base is empty. So empty, 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 empty. Unfortunately, we've also conducted reconnaissance over Matsui and Okayama and Takamatsu. These are occupied. There's subchasers here, so we're going to try. We're ordering the raid. My most ready force is actually the fortresses. Can you believe that? The fortresses are on the. And we're going to combine with Mitchell's, see if we can't knock out the ships at this base. So Okayama is getting it tonight. We're conducting recon over Okayama, Takamatsu, and just the two. Hiroshima is burning, well, not burning, but has enough damage. There's 3 points of naval shipyard damage, light industry 14 points, heavy industry 9, resources 8, merchant shipyard. So this is hopefully costing the enemy supplies, burning it up. Okay, that's good. That's the point of it. The liberators are still recovering. We're building like a son of a gun. We're at 50% now. Come on, push it. Push it. We've got transport sitting here at Keijo, just training and waiting. Okay, we may as well train. While we're sitting here, we've got excess, a little bit of excess aviation support. Not by much. We have maybe 60. Yeah, about 60 additional. While the other ones are sitting at Changchun, waiting for it to come up down the railroad. Over at Kotao, we're still trying to reduce the fortress. We've chased these units into the field. We have 5,900 now. We're going to go on the attack. Should wipe them out, hopefully, in one turn. Over in Singapore, I think this will be the last mission. Once we pull the submarines back, yeah, I think it's the end of the month, we'll send them over to Hong Kong for the gauntlet. Not doing much use here. We got our fighters sitting down, resting. We've moved the two anti-aircraft units back to Singora to try to clean up this mess. Should be another turn and then we can probably get out of here. Trying to get the Chindits out of there. They got off the railroad. Now try to get them back on the railroad. Should I try to upgrade these guys as... No. Let them die as they are. Rangoon, bringing in 44,000 more supplies. Impal, we have no additional reinforcements. Here's a base force coming through, and another one behind it, some battalions. Still struggling to get supplies out of Chittagong. The only thing we're trying to get out of here are the transports, but we don't need them right away. These transports are some of the biggest planes around, so they could conceivably... How do you know? You take a look at this and say the aircraft and check out. All right, maximum load. Well, does that mean it can carry the howitzers for the Chinese army? I don't know. Well, why don't you know? That's what staff is for. There's no easy way to find this out. Whether or not something fits on the damn plane. Oh well. The other transports are recovering. Yeah, no, there's no rush for these guys. Let's move these over to Chongqing. If we can. There we go. These other ones are still repairing. We just put a couple of more squads on the aviation base. We put 8 over here. That's right. That's all we need. Just to hold it until the Chinese can come up and kill this column. So now these guys can go back to training, rebuild. Better not be training. Let's just let them rest. Well, no, I need to keep one squadron in the west just in case. It's a just in case squadron. So we'll send the bigger, I think these guys are bigger, C-40s. Yeah, these guys care. Oh, maximum load 6,000. These guys have a little bit bigger, better range, 13 and 16. So I'll send these. I'll keep a squadron of C-47s over here just in case to move something around in the backfield. Quiet on Ceylon. Oh, there's a lot of reinforcements at Madras. Okay, we'll turn. Well, we don't want to turn on all those. We'll turn on the reinforcements and upgrades for all the others. Also, let's get them moving strategically. And I'll take this one and set all for Kobe. All right. Let's move them down to Imphal. Anyone else? That was Madras. We're quiet on Colombo. Nothing in Bombay. Karachi, we have convoy coming in. Here are the escorts. Came out to meet them. Wow, look at all that damage we take just coming out, just sailing out here to meet them. Oh boy, oh boy. All right, heading back into Karachi to unload them. Here's a convoy heading outbound. We're, yeah, these guys are leaving, heading back to Abadan. Over on Aden, we have a couple of base forces here, or sorry, air wing units. Now, I guess it doesn't really matter whether I load them here or load them. I'll load them here because now I can, when I load them, they'll fit on the ships a little bit better in transport mode, and I could bring a few extra supplies from Aden over. So there's no rush. I could just use them, put them into an amphibious group, but there's no rush getting out there. They have to, once they get there, they still have to drop into strategic mode in order to get on the railroad. So I'm not really saving anything by getting that. If I was in a hurry, I would just use amphibious and move them over here. But I'm not in a rush. Not in a rush. A supply convoy reinforcement has arrived. Nothing we can do about it until it disbands in 3 days. And well, we've already got plenty of supply and fuel here. Just waiting for the supply ship, for the transports to return. Submarine check. No submarines are damaged so far. Nothing with, well, they are, my, there's incidental damage, yes. Checking the endurance. Truant already coming back. Seahorse called back last turn. Sturgeon on the way back, and Haddock needs a recall notice. Thank you. As well as the Jack. Yeah. Come home. All is forgiven. Torpedo check. Growler was the only submarine to fire torpedoes this turn, so she still got plenty of weapons. Did she fire? Or did she just evade? Maybe she just evaded. Difference between firing and evading. All right, so all submarines maintain patrols. On the Gold Coast, we have a retrieval convoy coming through. Still enemy submarines detected out here, but are they going home? Moving to the northeast. Unlikely. This one's moving to the west. So going through the Torres Strait. I don't know if these, well, we had an encounter up here, but we didn't kill anything. Here's the battleship group coming up. I don't know if we're going to make it in time with these guys. They want to load and go. We're unloading on Guadalcanal and then dropping into Tulagi to grab those other guys. Almost done. We have dropped, oh, half, over half, 60% already. Here's a convoy coming out. We've escaped. We're out of the submarine danger zone, so we'll let them go. No other activity here. We have the Glenstrae coming around. I am curious. Well, we'll decide. Yeah, I think she has to come in to get fuel. She's not going to make it otherwise. Maybe we'll go into, we might go into Brisbane, but either way, we have to drop in to get fuel. All quiet on Panama. At Pearl Harbor, we have a couple of tanker task forces unloading. Next turn, I thought about sending the, okay, the transports are ready. The assault transports, three of them. Form, oh, we'll go transport the APAs. I had originally thought about using the destroyers as escorts. However, looking further ahead, they upgrade in one day, so I may as well just leave them here to upgrade. These guys will take the minesweeper as escort, and that should be, well, that's plenty. That's there. We haven't encountered any enemy activity around here, so we should be fine. We should be fine. More convoys inbound from Pearl Harbor, from Vancouver, straight run, and convoys heading past. Coming in from San Francisco, West Coast. One tra there's a transport ready, Lambert. Okay, we'll form transport. Do I load him here? I think I'm just gonna load him here and send him off to Wake, or Guam, pardon me, Guam. It's only a few hundred, it's only a few thousand supplies. It's not a big deal here. Yeah, we'll just go directly. Reinforcement, Alameda. Another assault transport. Thank you for the button. Any other reinforcements? Holy crap. Well, lots and lots, but Alameda, Los Angeles, and that's about it. Los Angeles, San Francisco. Oh, we the AKE. Oh, great. We can send the AKE loaded, and the three tankers will also load, but we don't have any ground units to send right now. I don't want to spend points on these pissant little anti-aircraft artillery units. I want units that can kill. That means assault value. That's probably going to be Australia and or New Zealand. These guys I can do without. Vancouver, look at these, my special, the 1700, the 17s, look how long it take them to load, even at a major base like this. The troop transports are ready to go, so we're going to send them to Pearl. The 17s, I'll call them the, my special forces, are waiting to, we'll give them a full load and then send them down to New Zealand. Over on the islands, we're starting to re I'm starting to re retain the transports again. I've got the support ships up. I'm going, these combat or these ammunition ships needed an upgrade a long time ago. Well, I just haven't bothered because I didn't expect to put them into combat, into a combat zone. But we're heading for Japan, and I'm a little worried that when we bring them up to Shikoku, they might actually get bombed. So I'm ordering them to unload. Their upgrade includes some additional radar and anti-aircraft guns. So I'm going to try for it. It's a 21-day upgrade. I maybe it's a bad idea. Maybe I should just race for it. I don't know. But I saw how much trouble six Bettys can almost penetrate a combat air patrol of 100 aircraft. Really? Six Betty bombers are giving me so much grief when we were docked over on Chichi-jima that, jeez, what's gonna happen when I get a couple of hundred or three or more of the damn things up here? So I'm going to try to unload them. Of course, looking at the repair table. Of course, it was supposed to be done in one turn, and of course, it did not get done. Typical, typical, typical. Everything else has pretty much been repaired. So we're fixing up everything else in preparation for the invasion. I have ordered the tankers to see if we can upgrade. We'll know next turn whether or not the dry dock qualifies as a minimum shipyard size. Let's see how that works. So we're unloading these. Unless I want to send them back all the way to Pearl Harbor, I could, I guess, but I don't want to lose all that time. That's another month before I get them back in the back. I might just have to send them in as is. So these guys are unloading. I'm retaining them. I'm not sending them back anymore. Because I'm going to need a hell of a lot of shipping to get the stuff up to Shikoku. I'm also, here's some tankers. We're going to unload, try to get these guys. Same criteria. Well, these guys are supposedly don't need a minimum shipyard. Supposedly, these guys can just upgrade right here. Well, not this guy, but some of them can. Let's see how many of them we can unload and get to upgrade at Guam. We've got more transports coming in. These are smaller, but I like these ones. This is a pretty decent group of 14s, and they carry about 85,000, 84,000. So they're pretty fast, and they carry a pretty, well, okay, sorry. I'm counting the tanker with it. So without the tanker, that's about a 75,000. Well, I think I'm going to keep these guys too, just because we're going to need some serious lift to get units and supplies into Shikoku. So once again, I'm starting to accumulate. Accumulate transports. Okay, up on heading for Chichi-jima. I reorganized them so that we now have two amphibious groups. These and a third one. These are just carrying some extra trucks that got left behind by these base forces when we took over Hajima. We're sending these guys just to unload them at Hajima so that they can be complete units. But the other two are amphibious forces. I am ordering them up to Chichi-jima, but I'm not ordering them to unload. Why? Because I want a full day's unloading on the island in the assault. I'm not sure if I move up here and unload. Yeah, I think I'll get one phase of unloading, but I'm not sure if everything's going to unload in the same day. I would rather delay one day in order to make sure that the entire, all the divisions, all the amphibious vessels unload completely in one day than to go over 2 days. By going over 2 days, this is a land size too, so it's not like I'm forced to conduct an assault landing. And well, I guess I could unload. See, this is not an atoll. An atoll would force me to conduct a shock attack the first turn. So I'm thinking now, okay, let's unload. Let's go. Let's unload. Sure. The third group is my support, second wave support. They're just going to show up and they're just going to stay there and wait. The fast transports are also going to move forward. I guess I could order them to unload. But they might. I'm a little worried that because they're closer, they're only one hex away from Chichi-jima, they might actually arrive early, and they might be going in alone. And these guys don't have any cover, so I'm not going to do it that way. I will let the amphibious guys do it first. These guys will meet them on the objective and wait alongside the second wave. The battleships are going to do their thing. They're going to go in and try to hammer this baby, keep it suppressed. I've brought additional fighters up. I brought another squadron of P-47s into the fight. I've also brought some P-38s. These are in transshipment. Once they have a range of 33, so I can get them into Korea afterwards. This I'll be needing this base for transshipping the transports for the parachute brigades up here too. Let's see how, well, fingers crossed for the invasion. Night air raid Okayama. No hits. Again, a third time. Still nothing. We got the one sub chaser. They're small enough. Hopefully, they will be destroyed with one bomb hit. One my counter mine vessel and another sub chaser. I hope it's another sub chaser. Nope, I don't think we got him. Bombardment, Chichi-jima. Ah, great. Still hitting the ground troops. That's what I need to see. Suppress them. Invasion. Unloading. We're firing. And defensive guns fire back. He's still got three guns firing on us. Another assault. We're losing some armored car and some of the Aussie division. Invasion on Chichi-jima. We're hitting the troops. Good. Suppressing them. More unloading, more losses. Air raid on Okayama. The fortress and Mitchell's go in together. We hit a countermeasure coastal minesweeper and a sub chaser. One hit each. They're pretty small ships. Hopefully this will sink them. Another sub chaser is hit. I think it's a different one. I can't. I don't remember. Bombed again. Port hits. Port hits. I would hope we hit the repair facility, but I guess not. Lots of port hits. Okay. Did we get them? Have we killed the ships? I certainly hope so. Naval bombardment, Chichijima. We wasted bombardment, just hitting the air base and nothing useful. Chichijima, the invasion. We are firing on the Sasebo 7th Special Naval Landing Force. Enemy fires back. No hits re registered. The assault goes in. We lose some troops of the Armored Regiment as well as the 1st Australian. Some trucks are lost. Damn it. Invasion. Chichijima. The other invasion group fires. The assault goes in. We lose some combat engineers and a militia section from the 1st Australian. Damn it. Fighter sweep Hiroshima. No enemy encountered. Fighter sweep Kagoshima. Three Nates shot down. The enemy attacks Swetao. No defense. Fighter sweep Hiroshima. Nobody home. Kagoshima. No interceptors. Fusan under attack. Oh, great. Four Ida level bombers attack into 156 defenders. Three are shot down. Is that it? Should have shot them all down. Betty's attack Fusan. One shot down. Great for training. Great for training, like living target drones. Oh, looks like an E class is hit and a Sokotan, yeah, supposedly hit again. Bombing practice Akyab. Bombing practice Langkawi. The Venturas, 36 of them miss. God almighty, you're terrible. You suck. Bombing practice Tanjung Pinang. We disabled one squad and one support squad. Tanjung Pinang, another support squad disabled. Lots of bombing practice. Bombing practice Nakhon Ratchasima. Bombers hit Tanjung Pinang again, disabling two squads. That's good stuff. Wasting more bombs on Ratchasima. Amphibious landing, unloading. Bombardment, Chichi-jima. The enemy, well, my guns must be bigger than his. I take no losses and inflict several on him. Shock attack? Wait, this isn't an atoll. Okay, live and learn, I guess. I guess it's a type 1 or a type 2. It doesn't matter. You're going to be a shock attack. That's just... I thought it had to say atoll on it in order to force a shock attack. Yeah, that's... it's. But this is island size 2, so... my mistake. I guess an island size 1 or 2 will force a shock attack. Well, live and learn. Probably my last invasion of the atoll invasion of the war. Chichi-jima! 915-1. We reduced the fortifications to 0, and it's captured, destroying 1 kate on the ground. Looks like the enemy had the terrain in his favor. Leadership, he passed 1 leadership role, but failed another one. Oh, I don't know. I don't know what that means. He was already disrupted from all the bombardment, and the only thing I have going for me was shock. The enemy is wiped out. We take some minor casualties, but we still have to recover from them. And it's been assigned to the Australians with a little Aussie flag on it. Deliberate attack near in the field near Mishan. 368-1. We destroy 5 enemy units. But the 2, 4, 5, that means the border fortress survives. Deliberate attack Koh Tao. 40-1 odds. The border fortress survives. But their units are surrounded at Koh Tao, so it probably means that they're wiped out by attrition.